everybody. Welcome to Cape Rugby TV. It's Wednesday night, and nice to have you along. Of course, the friendlies at Western Bronx Rugby keep rolling out, as well as Super Rugby structures continue now as well. Big thanks to Hisense that has come on board as the official technical partner to Cape Rugby TV, and Score and Factory Shops Mobile App SA as well. So nice to have our sponsors on board that are supporting Cape Rugby TV. Absolutely vital to have sponsors come on board when we're in the development space, so to speak, which was one of the topics on Monday night at the media workshop, where we were talking to the various clubs. Hopefully you were there. There were a number of clubs, and you'll see those clubs shortly end up with their jerseys and also being on the show. But hopefully the jerseys will be on the back of our wall if it hasn't arrived on the wall already. On the panel with me this evening, Ishmael Dali. Hello, Ish.
JP, good to be back on the show.
Yeah, it's always nice to have you here. We know that your wheels are turning fast at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, I can't believe we're 2-3 weeks away from the start of the league. I mean, a couple of months ago we were speaking and we spoke about the end of the season. Now it's almost going great guns for the beginning of the season, so looking forward to that.
Lyndon Julies, I don't know, have we had you on the show this week?
This
I mean,
year?
At least not this week. Have we had you on the show this year yet?
Yeah, well, good evening, JP. Good evening, everyone. So, Score, yeah. So.
Yes, we see that.
Yeah, the Score.
Score. Yeah, of course, you would have seen the Score guys at Rugby, which is in your neck of the
woods. Yeah, up the road from me. Yeah, I was on the show the first week, so.
Yeah, you've been busy as well, nice.
Here.
Getting into the world of media, huh?
Yeah.
You've given up your day job.
Yeah.
For another day job.
Let's call it that, yeah.
Yeah. We're not going. We're obviously not going to say where you're working, but
let's not do that.
You're obviously doing something that you love doing.
Yeah. So it was a big step that I took. Something that I've wanted to do all along.
Yeah.
Brilliant support from my fiance and my family also. So
you're still involved with St. George's?
I am. Mean,
obviously,
very much.
Do we still have you as a PR for St. George's?
I don't know. We've been debating this for the last 2 years, season and a half now, really, so I don't know what the.
I don't actually know either.
I don't know.
I did ask the question, why is Lyndon on the show?
Maybe Score must appoint me as the official analyst or something. I don't know.
What are you okay, right, folks. He'll drag it out all night long. He'll totally get to the point where Wales are winning the World Cup. Right. Let's get straight into it, folks. We went out to Kells River over the weekend. Kells River having a bit of a friendly against the guys from Macassar. And as usual, a good turnout there and a lot of fun. Let's see what happened in the highlights.
We'll be right back.
Oh, what a game. What a game it looked like. At least all the boys from Kelsen were getting the season started, so to speak, just getting the ball rolling. And Makassa, of course, just entering a bit of a warm-up team there. So good to give the guys a run as well. And, of course, maybe not expecting too much too early-ish. For Makassa, good to have a run. We were speaking about it last week. And good to have a run against a team that's perhaps in a higher league than you.
Yes, of course. And you can always sort of gauge yourself in terms of where you are and how you judge your team in another league. In saying that, it's still early days.
Yeah.
Season hasn't started yet. And Makassa is a team that they don't start off with a bang, but as soon as the season progresses, you know, they pick up their momentum slowly. And as soon as they get a win at home, they're very hard to stop.
Right, folks, that's the opinion of Ishmael Dolly. Let's take a look at the second half. We bring Lyndon Julius in the pitch and see what he has to say. It looks like the Cavs, let's just talk about Cavs over there, guys. 67-0 win for Cavs. You know, as I said earlier on, you can't really read too much into this stage of the game, do you?
Yeah, I think also that Cavs River should, obviously this is the start of the season. I think with the bunch of the influx of new players, they would probably just want to get the combinations and the sort of the team culture and chemistry going. But I think as you compete in Super League A, you want to have one or two losses, so you want to have that feeling of looking at the scoreboard and not being in your favor when and not doing it in season when it matters, you know. Because if you travel to teams like Hamilton or to Marty's, you don't want to be looking at the scoreboard and saying we could have done more. So I'd rather do that in pre-season and then hoping for a good opposition, a good side, and then going forward. So hopefully with the next two weeks, Girls River will be a bit softened up, you know, so that my good friend can bag a win, you know.
So, Ish, if we just look at it from a technical aspect, yeah, looking at the highlights there, the Makassa defensive lines didn't look all that stable, and we saw a lot of handoff passes, at least passes going to hand and players finding the gaps, and it's going to be different. It's going to be different against the likes of the other teams in Super League A.
Definitely, and you can clearly see that there's a couple of new faces in Kales River's mix. Not to mention John Lee Clausen moving from Hands and Arts to Kales River, Wade Skoor.
Yeah.
So these guys obviously are bringing a new energy, bringing a new vibe, and that's great for the club because that lifts the spirit. Like all other clubs where new players come in, the energy and the fierce is always up. So the challenge for them is going to be can they maintain that and the opposition is not going to be as easy as they got last weekend.
Well, Well, you obviously have to get those runs out the way and get the players. I mean, it certainly looks like the players are gelling. If we just take the competition factor out of it, it looks like they knew where the ball was going. They were getting the ball through the hands, which looks like the team has got a bit of synchronization there.
There's a bit of fluidity, and which is great to see. I mean, especially with a lot of new guys in, you don't really get that synergy very easily. In saying that, the sevens experience that exists within the culture of a squad is imminent. I mean, you can just see with the type of passes that they're throwing and the flicks and the offloads and the support running lines. That's great to see, and that will come in definitely handy in Super.
Right, folks, a little bit later during the course of the show, you can enter the score competition. All you need to do is SMS the word score to 33280 that you see on the screen now, and you can win yourself a case of score. Just SMS to 33280. Terms and conditions apply. All right, so we managed to catch up with Ryan Harris. He's the coach at Macassar.
If I look to our game, our fitness is not up to standard, so we had to work on our fitness. And defense was also a problem for us, so we need to have a look on our defense, even at the ruck defense, our backline defense. I think there's where Coles River, they make use of, our pillars wasn't in place, and the plays come through our pillars, so we had a look at that. And secondly, they had a good backline throws. So we were well tested, at the backs. So we need to look at our defense at the backline. The goals for us is just to see if we can play well-structured games. And our short-term goal is to end maybe second or first in the first half. Well, we will speak about or we will just talk about in a one-on-one with the guys, and we will see if we can work on our structured attacking lines and our defense.
All right, so Ryan Harris, coach there at Macassar. Dylan, Lyndon, the Ryan Harris quite well.
Yeah, Ryan was, he's got quite a good experience at few clubs, community-based clubs, the Northerns and Wraithby, and then, he's a good guy to have at Macassar. I think also someone with a perspective outside of Macassar, because Macassar have always had a Macassar-based or a player that played for Macassar coaching them. So I think they're in for a good season with Ryan there. You know, he brings a lot of forward presence or a lot of forward style coaching. But I think he will do good.
And of course, it won't be new to him. I mean, moving from Wraithby to in the same vicinity, he'll know most of the guys.
You will know the complement of players and the dynamics of players and their environment or what kind of player plays there. The same type of player, so it will be easier for him to transition from that. Just.
Well, we also caught up with Owen McCallum. He is the assistant coach at Macassar.
Ja, sommige tijden daar is open, sommige tijden daar is open, maar je hebt een punt te maken rondom onze players. Als het begin, ik van ons players, wat dacht ik, een paar minuten van ons players, wat dacht ik, een keer kans te spelen. Als ik was koning wat ik wil gebruiken, maar ons fit is het toe laten, want ik van die ons wat een beetje fit is, moeten we andere mannen zijn werk doen. En dit is een beetje voor ons geknie houdt die dag. Maar van Kool CV, ik denk alle fit is redelijk op een goede. Op een goede level. En ons kan nog wel bij leren bij rondom zekere aardes, wat is een plek kan zetten. Maar weer eens, van kans weer voor en toe, maar dan moet je maar het voortbouwen op dit wat er heet. En ik denk, om zo gelijk aan te spelen, moet je mentaal sterk wees. En je moet fysiek sterk wees, maar wees daar van bij je. Als een sportpersoonlijkheid is dat, mentaal gaat veel duurder aan wedstrijden. Want als we tegen waar het misschien gaat zwaar komt, maar dan komt eigen gedeelte bij. Ik denk dat ze redelijk goed doen. Als we kijken naar het fucked level, zullen ze redelijk goed doen. Maar als we ook houden van de strakjes, wat in een plek gezet vallen, zullen ze ook goed doen. Maar als de fucked recht is en dat is mentally sterk, dan denk ik dat ze dat doen. We hadden ons het voor ons al niet doorwitte. Maar als je niet die andere gedeelte zijn plek hebt, dan fucked it. En een krachtwerk en nog goed is wat daarbij moet komen. Niet een plek eten, dat is wel moeilijk. Maar als je daar goed een plek hebt, dan zal alles voor jou wegloopen. Ik denk dat we een beetje meer harder werken op onze vakzet. Ik denk dat de gamestructuur zal een plek vallen als de eigen deel een plek gezet is.
Owen McCallum there is, of course, the assistant coach at Macassar. I'll go back to you, Lyndon. Yeah, you seem to know quite a lot about Owen's history.
Yeah, Owen is a very prolific runner back in his day, yeah. Cross-country runner. He regularly posts up photos of yesteryear and seeing the man in full fight. He hasn't picked up much weight, you know, so, but I think he still keeps active, you know, training the kids in Macassar, yeah. Taking them for runs throughout. And he's a good servant of Macassar rugby and the community as well. Along with guys like Godfrey Africa, Stewart Africa, his brother Rodney McGallum, who's a lot involved with the juniors at Macassar.
Again, a big family scenario, yeah, big family structures, families looking after teams.
Yeah, it is, and with the limited resources that a community like Macassar has, and like any other community, with their troubles and whatever is happening, yeah. You know, off the field, they still make it work. You know, have a good junior structure and a very good club.
Well, they seem to be getting a bit of support now, yeah. from local business. Yeah. But talking about Godfrey Africa, we managed to catch up with him on the side of the field. He's, of course, the chairman at Macassar, and you will remember him from the Score Sevens competition, especially when the event was at Macassar on that final day. He was instrumental in organizing the Score Sevens competition. Let's take a look now at what Godfrey Africa, chairman of Macassar, had to say.
So we take it week by week, step by step. We've chosen to play against this team because we know that if we play against Super AE League teams, you know, it gives us a better test. So fantastic. The day was a bit marred by, you know, the death of one of our under 20 players early this morning. So we thought it just fit to stick to our commitment to Kelsover. At some stage, some of our players didn't want to come and play, but you know, all went well. We played all four teams, and I think, you know, it's just a stepping stone that we've used this week to get to the next level. Next week we're off because we have the funeral, and then the week after that we have a last friendly before the league starts.
Godfrey Africa, of course, the chairman at Macassar, having a lot to say there as always, but as I say, instrumental in making sure the boys at Macassar are always active. Right, folks, as I said earlier on, if you want to win yourself a case of a Score energy drinks, then all you need to do is SMS the word SCORE to 33280. Get on your cell phone right now and just SMS the word SCORE to 33280, and you'll put yourself in line to win a case of a Score energy drink. Of course, Score was the official sponsor of the Score Sevens competition that happened earlier in the year between, or at least that took place at Blake's and Wraithby and Macassar. So nice to see Score getting involved now in community sport. Right, folks, I'll announce last week's winner in a minute or so, so don't go away. We'll see you after the break. It's Cape Rugby TV here on Cape Town TV. We come to you every Wednesday night between 9 o'clock and 10 o'clock, and of course with a repeat on Saturdays in the morning from 9 to 10 in case you missed the show. All right, folks, we got some more action from Cales River, including some interviews with John Lee Clarkson, who's certainly became sort of a household name on Cape Rugby TV over the last few years. And John Lee is getting better and better, better and better by age. And we also caught up with Wade Squirt, that big guy that you saw playing for Kells over there with those fancy offloads and even a little grubber kick that ended up in the hands of Snares as he went over to Score. And let's catch up now with John Lee Clarkson and Wade Squirt and some of the boys from Kells River.
Yeah, it went well. I think the guys played well, and yeah, big ups to the guys. They stick to the structures and everything, and yeah, well done. I came from Primrose to Kells River. What a great team, great spirit. I love it here, and yeah, I really love it. And what can I say? The support, community, everybody behind us, the team behind Kells River, and yeah, it's just nice. Well, my main goal is just to stay stay fit to be in the first team, and after that I think on provincial level. But well, my big goal is to do good for Kells River first, and after that we'll see.
Yeah, I mean the Giers is very nice, and yeah, what can I say? It's a nice club. Giers is nice. I came here for my first time, and everything was just great. Felt at home, and yeah.
Ja, is lekker hier bij Kells River. Die Giers is lekker. Van de eerste dagen wat ik gekomen hier, ik heb zomaar thuis gevoel. En ik wil net mijn beste doen die jaar voor die club. En een goede season in Super geaaid. Voor die 45 minuten was het nogal lekker om samen met Owens te spelen. Het gevoel tussen dat te krijgen. Maar het gaat net, hiervan gaat het net bitter en bitter gaan. Maar het is bijna lekker geweest. Ja, ik zie nogal uit van Super Liga A. Ik wil nog een Super Liga A spelen, maar ik zie uit. Ik zie uit aan het team wat ons heet. Dan denk ik ons kan het maken. Dus Owens, het is heel lekker. Hij is nog een beetje haakplekken, maar hij is net wat ons kan. Maar dus ik kan richt maken op die oefenveld.
John Lee Clarkson there having a bit of a chat, as well as Wade Skuur. Mish, you seem to have a bit of knowledge on Wade Skuur.
Yeah, Wade made the Western Province amateur team, Western Province emerging team last year.
Yeah.
Did quite well, played for Primrose.
Is one of your boys? Were you coaching him?
Yes, in the Western Province emerging team. Played Super A for Primroses, and obviously I made the move to Kells River. So he'll bring a bit of experience and a bit of grunt, and you can see he's got some skills as well that he can implement and bring into the game. Mm.
The other player, of course, that we interviewed there was John Lee Clarkson, and then very talented and has the ability to not only set the back line away, but also to break the line.
Yeah, I think, like you said, rightfully said, John Lee is a household name. Everyone knew John Lee was either at Hands and Hearts or at some club in the Krafontein area. To see him move to Kells River, obviously, like you said, it's good to be in the Super League A. And also, he's got the ability to set the back line alight, and also to bring that bit of experience, because although he looks fairly young, John Lee has been around in club rugby for a while now. I mean, he's got experience of playing first team rugby for the toughest, against the toughest of competition. So I think the coaches at Kells River would call on that during the season.
Ish, how important is experience at a club rugby level versus flair and speed and so on?
Very important. I think it's important, even the flair and the youth as well. The key as a management or coaching staff is to get that balance, you know, so that's not too much experience, or there's not too many young guys, but to get that balance and sort of manage it and sort of coax it into a way that it will work for that specific team. John Lee Clarkson's biggest challenge will be his defense in Super A. They'll target his channel the whole day, every single day. So he's going to have to man up and stand up to that challenge. I believe he has the ability to do it. He has the ability to unlock defenses as well, and I think that's why he will fit in well with Kells River's game plan, especially the flair and the width and the pace and the speed of which Kells River plays. So he'll fit in well.
Yeah, so of course Kells River got the new backline coach, Mark Woodard. Mark, of course, we've had him on the show many times, everybody out there knows Mark. World of experience, played for Western Province Rugby as well. He's now coaching the back line at Kells River. Let's catch up with Mark Willard.
Yeah, I'm quite happy, with our start. I think it's early days to say too much. I ask the guys just to keep to the structure, do the little things right, don't play too expensive rugby. And I'm quite happy with our performance today. I mean that is the qualities of a good team. Even the scoreboard is ticking, you still keep your structure, keep the patience, the stuff that we worked on during the week, try to get that in the fold. And yes, as I said, it's a good start for us. Now the way forward is, we can just build on that, keep the ball alive on the points, because it's not always about just one ball and then you're going to score in this league. You must be patient. Because we're playing against more structured defense games to come. But I'm quite happy for the start. It's a good start, especially on the mental side of it. I'm quite chuffed with the opportunity. It's great to put something back to a new community, a new area. Yes, it's closer to home. To me, it's all about giving back. And it's nice to work with guys who want to be helped, you know, want to work on their finer stuff. And yeah, I'm actually very, very glad to have a good supporting coaches with me.
Mark Willard, a world of experience, Isha, as a backline coach. I always thought of Mark as more of a forwards coach. He was a forwards player. I think he played eighth man and flank for Western Province. Of course, he's moved across from Belhar now. Mark's experience as a backline coach, or do you think it's not going to matter?
No, I think he brings him, as I said, the experience again. He's been coaching in Tupai for a very long time and played at the provincial level as well. So he knows what it's like to play at the very top. And Kuilsriver, just recently being promoted, they need that experience in terms of what the rigors of Super. Remember, the league changed over the past couple of years. There's 15 teams, that's one shot against one team. So he understands the dynamics and he'll be a good guiding light, especially for the new coaching staff within that Kuilsriver management.
Right. Yeah, I also think that given that he worked with guys like Norman Jordan and Bronson Weir at Belhar, he was the head coach there for the last two or three seasons. So he was a senior guy there. So I think he was involved in all areas of the game. So I do think that although he was a formidable flanker or a formidable forward in his playing days, I think Mark Willard brings, as he said, a lot of experience to Kuilsriver, but also a good approach to the back line as a guy who really knows the Super League A game, you know?
So just in terms then of the backline players, how long will it take them to adjust to the coach? Because now we're talking about some new guys that are coming into the backline. I don't know, maybe I should throw this one at Ish at you, because you're a former international legendary backline player.
Japanese club player, Australian, Western Province, South African under 20.
Junior World Championships,
you know, I don't know if he played
sevens,
somewhere street rugby also.
Rugby.
He's like the Herschel Gibbs sevens, of rugby, like the Herschel Gibbs. Yeah, it's all over.
Yeah, he's like the Herschel down. Gibbs of rugby.
Yeah, I don't
did
know.
You just say the
it's
Herschel?
All over. Yeah.
It makes him be playing
on the
for
field.
Wales. Did he play for Wales?
I think he did, yeah.
Ish, okay. You guys have too much score.
Yes, we had a lot of score. Yeah, we had a lot of score. And, clearly, the energy is flowing here now. Ish, let's go to you. Mark will be looking to get these guys to gel very quickly. I mean, we saw them gelling earlier on, but you've got some new guys, you've got some old guys, and you've got a new backline coach.
I think Lyndon mentioned earlier, their real test will probably come this weekend. They're playing St. George's. And then the following weekend, they'll be playing Mullerton. So it will be a good test the next 2 weeks now, just to see and sort of gauge again, sort of a bit stronger opposition to see where they are once they take on that league, because it's about 3 weeks left before the first league game. And it's not a lot of time left. And exciting things happening at Kuilsriver. It's important that they maintain this intensity and momentum. It's easy to get burnt out. It's not a sprint. It's a marathon. And
well, tonight certainly does look like it's a bit of a Kuilsriver highlight show. We've still got quite a lot of inserts coming up on Kuilsriver. As I said earlier on, if you want to win yourself a case of Score, just SMS the word Score to 33280 and you can win yourself a case of Score. Congratulations then to last week's winner, David Slater. David Slater wins a case of Score, and the guys from Cape Rugby TV we'll, of course, be in touch with you soon, David, as you can get yourself ready to come and fetch your case of Score energy drinks. All right, a little bit later in the show, folks, we'll give you an opportunity to win yourself a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone, as well as a Second Skins prize to the value of R200, courtesy of Factory Shops SA mobile app. We'll talk about all that and more after the break. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, Cape Rugby TV. Remember, you can find us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV, and you can share your posters. So if you were in the media seminar on Monday night, you would have found out the format in terms of how to get us your posters. Two critically important thing there is we need to see the Cape Rugby TV logo, and we need to see the correct Western Province Rugby Football Union logo. Make sure you don't just copy the wrong one off the internet. Make sure you have the correct logo. Right, folks, we continue with our conversations with the players at Kuilsriver. Kuilsriver's, of course, done a sterling job in recruiting some superstars. And one of them is Charlton van Jaarsveld. Now, Charlton, of course, played at UWC, and then he moved to Tigerberg, and I think he went to study a little, didn't he? Came back, well, just before his Tigerberg stint. And now we see Charlton van Jaarsveld Kelsey. He's captaining the side there. Of course, he played hooker at UWC, and a great leader for Kelsey to have.
Yes, I'm quite happy with our performance. A lot that we can take from it, but a lot we have to work on for the next game. But I'm quite happy with it, yeah. I'd say it's a great feeling being here by Kayla. Yes, we won the Super B next year. That's a new league, new challenges, but we're up for it. And yeah, we're mentally ready for the game. We know it's going to be tough, but we're not here to fill up the league. We're here to compete. The first goal basically is to stay in Super League A, but we, like I said, we're not here to fill up, we're here to compete. So we want to win and want to do good. Yeah.
Charlton van Jaarsveld, yes, there, captaining at Kelsriver. Kelsriver must be thrilled to have Charlie there.
Absolutely, what a role model to club rugby players. This guy was in the Western Province Carrie Cup squad not too long ago, a couple of years ago, and I think he broke his leg he injured himself quite badly. Yeah. So he's got a lot of talent, and it's good to have a leader like him in the team. He's obviously going to bring his experience as well as his leadership capabilities, which will rub off to the rest of the squad.
Played a couple of teams.
He was at Tigerberg, and then Salarin as well for the PC. I'm not sure if he finished off last year. But I do know that he does the UWC as well. And then I do know that he put his studies ahead of his rugby, which, as he said, is a good role model for all club rugby players, thinking that, you know, you can make a living off club rugby. I mean, Ish has been in club rugby. I mean, we've all seen how club rugby pans out, that you really can't make a living off club rugby. So it's good to see the guys like Charlie, you know, putting in the hard yards off the field and then enjoying his rugby now. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's so many other examples out there, but I think Kelsriver is definitely very happy to have a guy like Charlie van Jaarsveld there.
Well, it's nice to be highlighting so many of these players in club rugby. Alternatively, possibly the guys might not have been given the exposure. So thrilling for us to see so many of the Kelsriver boys getting exposure tonight. Right, folks, as I said earlier on, you can win yourself a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. This is it in my hand. And if you want to win this, all you need to do is go to a Facebook page and SMS, at least not SMS, but go to our Facebook page and tell us who's the official technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. Win a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone with a KitKat Android, a 5-inch multi-touch screen, a 4G LTE dual SIM, and an 8-megapixel rear camera with LED flash. Okay, so you want to win the Hisense Infinity Pulse. Hisense is, of course, our technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. So just jump on Facebook and tell us who is the technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. It's as easy as that. You put yourself in the mix to win a Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. We'll take an ad break, and when we come back, we're going to catch up with some more of the boys from Kelsriver. Right, folks. As I said earlier on, if you want to win yourself that Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone, just go to Facebook and tell us who is the official technical partner to Cape Rugby TV. All right, so as we said earlier on, Kelsriver continues to be in the spotlight. Of course, we would have liked to talk to more of the Macassar boys during the course of the show. Unfortunately, they had a few other matters to deal with on the day. I'm not going to elaborate on that, but our thoughts go out to the boys at Macassar. And know that Cape Rugby TV stands firmly behind you guys, and we know that you've got strong spirit in Macassar. We managed to catch up with Donny Isaacs. Is of course from Kelsriver. We get the final word from the boys at Kelsriver before we move on to the Super Rugby and Super Brew and club friendly highlights.
It was the first home game for Kelsriver, and the atmosphere once again was absolutely electrifying. I think everybody was waiting in anticipation for today, and I think the club delivered, yes. The key was that they actually started in perfectly well. They've been training since November last year, and you can clearly see that they're part of the Kelsriver family, so I'm very happy for them. They have started in nicely, and you can see they fit into the game plans of the club, so I think they're going to be very successful this year. In general, club rugby this year is going to be very, very good. There's been a lot of movements in clubs, and we've seen this on the show over the past couple of weeks. We've seen Tigerberg, we've seen the Hammies, we've seen Falls Bay. So it's going to be very, very exciting. Player movement probably is not that important. I think player development is key. So if a player wants to move to a club where he feels that he's going to be best utilized in his current position and it might be at a different club, so be it. At the end of the day, it's Western Province rugby. And if you can develop players at various clubs for the good of the union, I'm all for it.
Donny Isaacs from Kells River giving us his insights there into the plans for the season. I'm sure Kells River is going to do really well. It was, of course, on Friday night, the launch of the SCORE Easter Weekend Festival that's happening at Blake's. And the boys were out there in full force. A lot of the Western Province rugby officials were out there as they launched the competition that's coming up this Easter weekend. It's at Blake's. We were out there last year and it was a fantastic event with lots and lots of teams. Let's take a look at some of the photographs from the night. Folks, there you see it. SCORE, of course, 100% behind the Easter Rugby Festival that's happening over at Blake's. Cape Rugby TV will, of course, be there as well. And I think in the week leading up to that, we'll be catching up with Aubrey Noble. We'll bring him on the show and he'll be able to tell us a little bit more about that event that is coming up at Blake's on the Easter weekend. But yeah, it looks like SCORE is all over the show. And certainly the guys are wearing the kit that is... going to be quite prominent on the day, so quite a couple of clubs there now in the SCORE kit. Right, as I said earlier on, you can win yourself that Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. Congratulations then to last week's winner, Romero Marwood. Romero, you walk away with the Hisense Infinity Pulse cell phone. The guys from Cape Rugby TV will be in touch with you shortly. Now, incidentally, if you do have an Android phone or even an iOS phone, then you can download the Factory Shops SA mobile app. All right, you can download, of course, Factory Shops mobile app is one of the kind supporters to Cape Rugby TV. There you see it on the screen right now. Just download the Factory Shops mobile app and name any of the Factory Shops listed on the app and give us your answers on Facebook. The website, Facebook page there, www.facebook.com/Cape Rugby TV, and you can win yourself a Second Skins voucher to the value of 200 Rand. Just download the Factory Shops SA mobile app and tell us the name of one of the stores that are listed on the Factory Shops SA mobile app. Unfortunately, you can't tell us that it's Second Skins, because Second Skins is the one that's giving you the 200 Rand voucher to one of you lucky viewers that are out there right now. All right, folks, it's Super Rugby. It's kicked off now. We're now into our second week. The Stormers have had two wins on the trot, one at home against the Bulls, and then, of course, it was against the Cheetahs over the weekend. It was another strong win for the boys. Let's quickly look at the results before we start talking about the Super Rugby campaign. Crusaders beating Blues 28-13. The Brumbies win for them over the Waratahs. The Chiefs going down to the Lions. The Highlanders losing to the Hurricanes by just 1 point. The Reds losing to the Force. The Bulls beating the Rebels 45-25. The Cheetahs, well, it was a loss for them against the mighty Stormers, the DHL Stormers, and of course the Sharks 19-15 over the Jaguars. All right, Ish, let's talk to you about this one here. The Crusaders bouncing back.
Yeah, I think they've got what it takes, and this is a team that knows how to win championships. And it's in their DNA. They don't peak very early in the competition, but they know how to grind out their wins, and come knockout stages time, they will always be there in the mix.
All right. The Brumbies, winning for them over the Waratahs, they started strong last week, yeah. London, and I suppose this was an expected result.
Yeah, I think this was an expected result. I don't think that anyone expected it to be that far apart, or the scoreline to be so wide, given that it's a derby, and that a derby match is always something that is that you expect a low scoring if you look at the other derbies that took place over the weekend. So I think it's a good result for the Brumbies, yeah.
I'll tell you, the one result that actually blew my mind was the Lions beating the Chiefs.
Yeah. First
after
time.
What I didn't
yeah,
think
ever.
Was, you know, but they do this yeah. sometimes where they have an absolute misery, then they go south and then they have like four wins in a row.
But I think Elton Yankees and Faf de Klerk, the whole team in fact, they did pretty well. We all yeah. know the formidable loose trio of the combination on the flank of loose forwards of Warren Whiteley and Jaco Kriel. But I think Elton Yankees and
but still,
Faf
I mean,
de Klerk,
they just left South
good.
Africa. They travelled to Japan.
Yeah.
From Japan,
yeah.
they went
but
down
they had
to...
This, they had this fancy sleeping, you know, adjustable technology now where they... I don't know how it works, but then it's apparently that helps them to travel. But they have travelled a lot. But it's good to win the Chiefs at the Chiefs. I mean, you know, and they like you said, they have never done it before. And it's good for the Lions too.
Is this the issue? Their first win?
Yeah.
The first time the Lions ever beat
first
the
time
ever,
the Lions.
Ever.
In Hamilton.
And yeah, what a great result. Just the skills that were displayed by the Lions players, second to none, and stood out amongst all the games that were played over the weekend.
Too early to tell, but so far a good start. And then, of course, the Highlanders beating the Hurricanes by just 1 point. And then the Reds losing to the Force 22 points to 10. The Bulls, 45-25. After their performance against the Stormers, I thought the Bulls would go down to the Rebels. That was my Super Brew prediction. But they were a different team on the day.
It's weird to hear the coach saying that they were the underdogs in Pretoria in the week. But
yeah.
it's a step in the right direction. Weird with this whole new bonus point structure that not to get a bonus point out of a 45-25 match.
Just explain the bonus point structure to us.
So as far as I understand it, you got to score 3 more tries than your opposition. So if you've scored 10 and your opposition scores 8, you don't get a bonus point.
But you also got to be on the winning side also.
Yeah.
So like the Bulls were ahead for 45 minutes into the game, 42 points to 3. And then the Rebels just scored 3 tries in a matter of 10 minutes, and then a 4th try from the scrum off, Ben Meehan just took the game away from them. And I mean, that last 15 minutes, you would think that they would walk off the field.
But I also think, once again, that's a very young side,
yeah.
a Blue Bull side, and they've lost some key players, Springboks, that have gone on to greener pastures.
But also seeing the way that the front rankers, Trevon Yakane, Andre Strauss, and Van der Merwe, the ball handling skills, it shows that Nolas Maree, having coached at Tukkies and coming through the under 20 and under 19 ranks, you can see that there's a bit of, like you say, there's a lot of youth in the side, and ball wants to be thrown around. So I think that's good.
So it's not your traditional
blue balls.
I was going to bring that into the conversation.
No.
You know, 10 years ago or 5 years ago, we used to see the Bulls playing this stump car rugby, and they're playing a different running game now.
Well, their jerseys are not traditional anymore as well. I mean, camouflage and
the cheerleaders aren't traditional anymore either. So
I guess it goes with the territory.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're not wearing the old jersey, you're not going to play the old way. So, which is great to see. It's great for rugby, great for South African rugby. So I'm looking forward to. But just the Lions game for me was a standout.
Yeah, definitely. And then of course the match on Friday, or at least on Saturday afternoon. The big one for us was the DHL Stormers beating the Cheetahs. There was a moment there in the game that I thought, this is going to be tough. It's going to be tough to pull it through. And then we of course, lost Robert Tapria.
Yeah.
And Kurt Coleman came on, and he really showed his mettle. But before we talk about Kurt, the Stormers themselves, they look like they want to play. They look like they want to express themselves. And are still kind of busy getting to find their feet, but they look like a... We spoke about this before, that some of the older guys are gone now.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the old school guys, we're not seeing them around. That there seems to be a fresh energy amongst these fun guys. And certainly if you look at a guy like Jean de Jong, who can't stay off Instagram or stop doing selfies. him and Chez. There's
and
a
chair. There's a crew of them that does that.
Yes, 100%. Yeah. Khaleesi the bear. And, you know, there's a team of guys there that are really looking like they have freedom to express themselves and have fun. And, you know, to a certain degree, I see that Robbie Fleck in that. You know, I don't know how many people know Robbie Fleck, but in the years gone by, he wasn't the most well-behaved back in those days. He was a free spirit. You know, if you speak to the guys, he was always someone doing a little bit, something a little bit weird.
Out of the ordinary. Yeah,
come to practice with a dog or, you
know,
slip-slops. You know, so I'm seeing a little bit of culture come into this now, young culture. I'm seeing a little bit of a taste of Robbie Fleck. I'm seeing a bit of running rugby. I mean, are we getting back to what Western Bromwich rugby originally always used to be?
Definitely. And I think credit has to go to Robbie. I mean, he's not your very tensed up coach. You know, his relaxedness sort of exudes and it filters through to the players. And that's where that whole sort of free running rugby is coming. Remember, the Stormers are coming out of a very sort of successful defensive sort of game plan that they've adopted under the past regime. So Robbie Fleck brings that new dynamic energy, and I think it's untapped potential that's waiting to blow. And we haven't seen the best of them yet. Mind you, that Stormers kit looks absolutely superb.
I love it.
I thought the Reds were playing as Chiefs.
I was looking at it, and then from behind, I was looking, why does it look so familiar? And then I saw it looked like an Iron Man suit. Like, if you look from behind, like the red, and then going down to the shorts and the socks as well. And then one of the players had the red boots on as well. So I was like, you know, this looks like an Iron Man suit.
And looking from behind, if you look at the Stormers jersey, I thought that they had an Adidas vest on.
Yeah, like
you know,
like a vest.
Sort of like hooked on, and then turn around, the vest was gone.
And maybe that is why you find, you know, guys, I mean, like Leolan Zas, I mean, a kid, he's been thrown. He's still a kid, thrown in the deep end, playing the Cheetahs at Bloemfontein. Stormers haven't won there in 4 years, and then he goes up and then he plays like he's been there all along.
But that's the backing that Robbie Fleck has in his youngsters.
And I also think that, I think Dylan Leitz mentioned it sometime. He said that the gap between coach and players has been shortened now. So like you say, there's that relationship that is there. So I think not a friend or on first name basis, but there's that friendship to do what you want to do. And I think that is going on to the field. And guys like Skalk Burger, you know, not being as prominent in the game, but you can see his experience and leadership in guys like Nizamka, Sia Khaleesi, Sikambuza Noche. Like, these guys are playing with a bit more freedom. And I mean, last season alone, Sikambuza Noche was not as prominent on the field, but like now you can see he's taking charge. I mean, the try that he scored was really, you know, something.
Finding that gap.
Yeah, I mean, it's brilliant. Guy like Nizam Kaur can rest now because there's guys that can take over. Because I think last season, with him being captain or having to captain the side for some games, took a lot away from his game. Now he can do that. So Zohan de Jong. And then a guy like Fransmar Herber, a Springbok coming off the bench. I mean, that is something
to do. Okay, let's talk about the forward. I want to talk about the scrum, the Stormers scrum in a second, right, folks? So don't forget now, if you want to win yourself a second Skins voucher to the value of 200 Rand, all you need to do is download the Factory Shops Mobile SA app. All right, there you see on your screen right now. Go to the Google Play Store or to the iTunes App Store and download the Factory Shops Mobile app. Name any of the Factory Shops listed on the app and give us your answer on Facebook, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV, and you can win a second Skins voucher valued at 200 Rand. Of course, terms and conditions apply. Congratulations then to last week's winner, Corin Amissi-Watts. Well done, Corin. The guys from Cape Rugby TV will be in touch with you shortly. I love this app. It's a fantastic app. If you haven't downloaded it yet, do so now. Go to, as I said, to the iTunes Store and go and download the Factory Shops SA Mobile app. If you're looking for a store close by you, just do a search and the GPS coordinates will guide you right to that store, and also the contact details of that shop for the mobile Factory Shops app is on the phone. So you do your search, it locates where the store is and it takes you right there. Just going back to the Stormers quickly, the scrum itself looked like it was strong. There were at times on the odd occasion, we're running a little bit tight on time now, and we're going to wrap up with our Super Brew in a second or so, but there were times there that I could see that we had actually won the scrum, and then they just managed to get the push on.
Yeah, I think
which looked like we'd lost the scrum.
Yeah.
But I thought that the Stormers scrum were a lot stronger than actually we were given credit for.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the Cheetahs definitely did their homework the first week, knowing exactly at which point to unleash the power of the front row and then the locks backing. I mean, that is one hit. It literally takes a few seconds to get that over that power over yourself.
Ibn Etzebet, what an absolute
colossal
giant in and just absolutely making a mockery of
Luatiaga.
Don't you think that must have been absolutely fantastic?
Yes, and I think that's where the game was won. It was won at line-out time. And Ibn Etzebeth and Steve Tutoi, what a combination to have. Springbok, lock combination. Mm. And these guys are going to win many more games for us. Mm. Nizam Kwa had a brilliant game. I thought he was the most outstanding loose forward across both teams. Just in terms of his linkage play, as well as his involvement in most of the play. So I think those two players, as well as Kurt Coleman stepping in, getting rid of that hoodoo of last year, was very, very important for him going, especially into the season.
But again, showing his maturity, showing that he's settling into that position. And once again, I think maybe the coaching staff have started to get it together here that there's 22 players playing. Yeah. It's not 15 players.
Yeah, no, I think Robbie Flick and the guys, like Russell Winter and the guys helping Robbie Flick on his staff, they're definitely, like you say, they're getting it together, using Peter Steff and Ibn Etzebeth to their full potential. Nizam Kaur, a guy like Janu van Mark, who says he still wants to play for the Springboks. I mean, you get these guys still going into this. So I think it's a very, very good side, yeah.
Right, folks, so let's take a look at the Super Rugby fixtures coming up on the weekend. It's, of course, the Hurricanes against the Blues on Friday, starting the ball rolling at 8:30 in the morning. Then it's the Force and the Brumbies. On Saturday, we see the Highlanders take on the Lions, the Rebels and the Reds. On Saturday, also the Sun Wolves against the Cheetahs, and then the Kings against the Chiefs. And, of course, Saturday at 5:15 at Newlands, it's the DHL Stormers against the Sharks. So it's the Sharks on Saturday at Newlands. It's going to be an absolute cracker of a game. Make sure you get down there. Right, folks, Super Brew, of course. Let's take a look at this last week's top 10. Willy Wilkie is still at number one on Superbrew. Barnes, Rob 9WP, Naki Neil and 90, Adrian Jansari, FBI Speed, Daboul and Koch Yuan. Those are our top 10 in Superbrew this coming weekend. Stormers and the Sharks coming this weekend. The Sharks were not as good as I thought they were going to be against the Jaguars. We should take them.
We should take them. Just the way we're playing and the potential that we're showing, we should take this one. It's home ground advantage, and I'm sure the DHL faithful will come out in their droves to support our favourite side.
Yeah, you're feeling on it, Lennon?
Yeah, no, definitely. I'm agreeing with each on that. I think
Sharks.
Yeah. No, Stormers. Nice one. My score is wearing off.
Score's wearing off.
Yeah, I think the plays
just
that we've
talking about score, I'm going to leave you guys there. I'm going to let's stop it right there. We're running a little bit short on time. Just a quick congratulations to John Stain from Score. Incidentally, had a little baby girl on Tuesday. Congratulations, John, from Cape Rugby TV and the team. We wish you guys absolutely the very best. Ishmael Dolly, thank you very much for joining us here on Cape Rugby TV. We'll hopefully see you soon.
Absolute pleasure. Thanks for having me.
And Lyndon Julius, always a pleasure having you here with all your insights into the world of rugby.
It's always good to be here. Thanks for having me.
There we go, folks. We'll see you, of course, over the weekend at a club game near you. Big thanks to the guys from Score for coming on board with Cape Rugby TV, Score Energy Drinks, and of course Hisense in as our technical partner, and the factory shops SA mobile app. You've got to download that mobile app. We'll see you again next week, same time, same place. Have a fantastic rugby weekend. Bye bye.